According to President Museveni, the NRM government understood the necessity of big markets quite early and started working towards the economic integration of East Africa to benefit from the bigger regional and continental market of Africa.
Economies like USA, China, India, to mention but a few, are backed by big markets. If you produce on a large scale, you must have a big market to consume your products and services. Luckily for Uganda, the NRM understood the necessity of big markets quite early and started working toward the economic integration of East Africa to benefit from the bigger regional and continental market of Africa. We cannot be satisfied with Uganda's small market of only 42 million people. This cannot guarantee our prosperity.
The president commended Uganda Manufacturers Association for organizing this year's trade fair to showcase Uganda's products to the rest of the world.
By prioritizing investment in the development of physical infrastructure, the NRM government ignited Uganda's economy. We have started Uganda's industrial revolution, which has now taken root in all parts of the country. There are four sectors where households can create wealth and jobs for our young people. They are commerce, agriculture, industries, big or small, services such as hotels, transport, professional services, shops, etc., and ICT.
Harriet Ntabazi, who represented the Minister for Trade, said the quality of goods manufactured is good and puts Uganda in a better position to compete on the world market.
Check your quality. Check your standards. Check the way you do your things. Check your environment. Check your talents of marketing. Yes, pulling her down will not make us move. Ours, what will make us move is joining together cohesively, joining together, moving to another level, because we need as much products as possible.
This is a very, very strategic event for Uganda, not only to showcase products, but to market the country, what we are capable of doing. And right honorable, I can assure you both the chairman and the ED can testify that our presence here as exhibitors and as sponsors has made a difference.
Deo Kayemba, the chairman of UMA, says that the government needs to protect manufacturers in regard to taxes for their survival and continuity.
There is little thought given to the survival, sustainability, and continued growth of the taxpayers. And this is not helping the long-term growth of the economy. We therefore call upon the government to review and update Uganda's tax policy to ensure the certainty and sustainability of the tax regime and to encourage investment and growth.
The manufacturers and exhibitors are happy that the trade fair is making milestones in showcasing Uganda's capacity and promised to continue participating in the event.
Business recovery, but how? Through harnessing local sourcing and deepening value chains. And I'm happy that Dr. Msenero came to speak here about growing value chains before I did. Right Honorable, the trade fair has cast a major spotlight on manufacturers. It has confirmed once again that as manufacturers, we are the engine of this economy. And yesterday, the president was very clear in his independent speech when he threw down a challenge for the whole of Africa that we need to do more manufacturing.
Let me take this opportunity to reaffirm our commitment to sponsoring the 29th Uganda International Trade Fair, which will be next year. And indeed, the one that will follow in line with the MOU which we have recently signed between Total Energies and UMA to sponsor this one and the next two, meaning the 29th and the 30th.
This year, the trade fair was held under the theme Business Recovery by Harnessing Local Sourcing and Deepening Value Chain Integration. Report by Ismail Kasoha for the news.